And good evening, everybody. Welcome in to the Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week. Jim and Dale along with Zach. We're at Legion Stadium in Sylacauga for a big region matchup between B.B. Colmer, coming off an upset win over Randolph County last week against the Dadeville Tigers. And Zach, Dadeville coming in at 1-6 overall and 1-3 in region play. So it's a must win for both these teams tonight.
Yeah, you know, you can't say they've had an easy schedule. You know, they beat Lee Scott Academy, played Glenwood, Realtown, Randolph County, who B.B. Colmer beat. Dave lost 28-0. Played Hanley, Elmore County. Just a lot of good games this team, a lot of good teams Tiger team has played.
This is a region game, and, you know, B.B. Colmer lost to Glenwood 37-14 and some comparable scores. Randolph County beat Dadeville, and B.B. Colmer upset Randolph County last week and 36-34. B.B. Colmer had the lead 36-34 with just a handful of seconds left. Dadeville went for two, Randolph County went for two and made it, but they celebrated and the 15-yard penalty, so it pushed them back, negated the two-point conversion, and they missed it the second time, so B.B. Colmer comes away with a win. And so that helps the Tigers as they try to position themselves for a playoff spot. They got a ways to go, but this is a big game for them tonight.
Yeah, it definitely is. You know, you got to get a win right here. This is about your playoffs right here. I mean, you're fighting for three other teams to get a spot. You know, it's just every win counts.
It's our Automotive High School Game of the Week. We talked a little bit about B.B. Colmer last week. Ray Sims, he's everything to B.B. Colmer. Total yardage last week for him was well over 350 yards. Throwing and running the football. So Dave was going to have to slow him down for sure tonight.
Yeah, for sure. You know, he can throw the ball, he can run the ball, he can do anything. He can juke you out, run through you, and then throw a dot to the sideline. I mean, he's just an all-around great player.
All right, we've got Dadeville and B.B. Colmer, a region matchup in Class 3A, 3A Region 4. B.B. Colmer 2-3 in region play, and Dadeville coming in with one region win. Coach Adam Fawcett talked about last week's big win and looking ahead to tonight. The Coach Adam Fawcett Show coming up right now. Fawcett Show brought to you by Marble City Pharmacy here in Sylacauga, and a critical game for B.B. Colmer that not a lot of people gave the Tigers much hope against a Randolph County team that was a pretty good team. But B.B. Colmer goes on the road and upsets Randolph County 36-34. And to talk about it, head football coach, athletic director Adam Fawcett. And Coach, that was a nice win for you guys. Good morning.
Good morning. Yeah, it was a huge win for us, huge region win for us, and kept a playoff picture open for us and an option still alive. So, man, we did some really good things with the ball, obviously, putting up points. And Raylon Sims had a big game with his feet and throwing the ball. So, he rushed for two touchdowns. He threw for three. Richard Weed had three touchdown receptions. And the difference, you know, the difference in this game and in two previous close games that I felt like we definitely should have won is two-point conversions. And, you know, we were able to capitalize on most of our conversions and end up winning by two. So, just a big game for us. Defensively, we played really, really well in containing their back. Their back's probably he's probably the second best back in the region that we see. And the week before against Glenwood, even though they Randolph County lost to Glenwood, the week before that back had like 335 yards rushing and, and five touchdowns. So we did a good job containing him to the best of our abilities. Ja'Kari Brown and Caden Brown had big games for us defensively. De'Aaron Riley stepped up and had a huge game with 12 tackles, two sacks, and a interception. So just a lot of guys stepped up and played. And, you know, that effort, you know, seeing what they're capable of doing, especially going on the road in a game that they're not supposed to win, you know. And I explained that to them before the game, like, you know, nobody has us, you know, circled on their list of winners for the night. So it's about the ones in the room. It's about us. And, you know, we have a lot of people that have already shut the door on us. We have people within our just within some of our kids' circles that have shut the door on them. So, you know, it's about the guys in the room. It's about the coaching staff that's with them and fought to the end with them. And we're going to just keep getting after it.
Randolph County is never an easy place to play.
No, it is a tough environment. Very, very tough place to play. It was a unique night, mm-hmm. For sure. You know, at one point in time, I put us in a bad situation. I ended up getting a flag. I put us in a bad situation and put, you know, with the penalty, it put the Randolph County in the red zone, and our guys stood up and got a stop, you know, and it was...
Do your players punish the head coach when he's flagged?
No. Generally, they don't, you know. Somebody from, I don't remember who it was, but, you know, the flag happened, and I'm, you know, I wasn't even mad before the flag, but the flag happened, and I'm trying to figure out what's going on. And one of the guys, and I don't remember which player it was, and they yelled over to the sideline, like, "Coach, we got you, you know. So, but that fired everybody up for sure. And you know, you get a stop there and you're able to go ahead.
Is this a Tiger team you've been looking for?
Yes. Yeah, this is a group that I knew the capabilities were there. I knew that the ability was there. So, you know, this is a group that if you carry that energy over into this week and the next week and the next week, some really good things could happen. And again, you look at records and you look at all the other stuff. You throw the record stuff out the window. We've seen some great improvements from all of our guys. You know, we've talked about Ray's growth and maturity and handling adversity better, and he's been able to do that. And you know, for Randolph County, we kicked off to them the first or second play from scrimmage. Ja'Kari Brown blows the center up. And they fumble the ball, and we get the ball back. Well, our second play from scrimmage, Ray fumbles the ball. Well, instead of just, you know, getting beside himself and upset, he turns around, goes and plays defense, and we get the ball back. Or they score, we get the ball back, we go score. So, and it came down, we told them during the week, it comes down to we've got to get more stops than they do. And we were able to do that. And for most of the game, we had a two-score lead. You know, even if we gave up a score, we'd come back and score. So we gave up a cheap score on a kickoff return for a touchdown. And, you know, I'm kicking myself for that. And we've discussed that a lot this week, mm-hmm. is being aware and staying in your lanes and wrapping up and doing all the things that you're supposed to do. So in doing that, I think you look at, you know, Randolph County scores to make it 36-34, and you talk about discipline, you talk about understanding football, and I wish kids understood football. Kids now understood football as much as I guess kids in the past. You know, they don't watch as much football. They don't sit down and watch football on Saturdays. They'd rather, you know, play it on a video game, which is completely different. But the one of the differences for Randolph County was when that kid scored, he jumps up and spins the ball and gets in one of our guys' faces and gets a penalty. So now their two-point conversion, instead of being on the three, is on the 18. Mm-hmm. So that helped us a ton and hurt them. But, you know, at the end of the day, we played well. We went to a wild environment and picked up a win.
So
You know, you talked about the young man being penalized after the Randolph County touchdown. It seems like, just from the naked eye, that we're seeing more and more of that. And the discipline part of playing high school football is driven by what they see on Saturday and on Sunday.
No doubt. Yeah, it is 1,000% driven by that. And unfortunately, at the collegiate level, they're letting them get away with more and more. And obviously on Sundays, there's really not too many things that you can't do celebration-wise. Yeah. So I tell our guys, you got to act like you've been there before. If for some reason a lineman scores or something like that, you know, and they haven't been there before, it may be a little different. But, you know, even in a big, you know, a big score to go ahead or a big score to tie the game, or in this situation, a chance to tie the game, you've got to do what's best for your team. And it's not about that individual score. So it's still key to act like you've been there before. And
talk about how important Sims is to this team.
As he goes, we go. He's the true leader of the team. He's the one that gets the guys going, and his energy. He's not going to be a vocal leader as far as, like, you know, getting on the guys, yeah. But his energy really bleeds off onto others. And when he's got when his energy's up and he's performing and doing the things that he's capable of doing, everybody wants to follow that.
So. And you're looking for that consistency mm-hmm. from 1 week to the next.
Yeah, we've got to be consistent. You know, we've got to, there's things that, in every game, there's things that you can do better. And we're looking for those things that we can do better. Obviously, this week we've got to tackle better. Dable has a group of athletes, a group of skill guys that can move, and in open space, they're dangerous. So we've got to do a better job making sure that we get to tackles and we get 11 guys to the ball.
These region games, we're getting close to the end of the season mm-hmm. now. They get bigger and bigger, don't they?
They do, and the region has been a fruit basket turnover, because there's a ton of teams. I think us, Lee Scott, Randolph County, I think all three of us are at 2-2 in the region. We have Daveville and Lee Scott left. Randolph County has Childersburg and Beulah left. Glenwood pretty much has the region wrapped up. They're 5-0 in the region. Beulah is sitting at 3-2 in the region. It's kind of there's basically five teams right now fighting for four spots. And the only thing we can do is control what we can control. And I've explained that to the guys. You know, we've got to win this one, and then we'll see how the rest of the region shapes out after Friday and see how it goes. But I may be wrong about this, but looking at the region, if we win one of the next two, okay, we would need Beulah to go to Randolph County next week and beat Randolph County for us to get the four spot. If we win both of the next two, and depending on some other things that happen in the region, we could possibly finish two in the region. So it's just kind of, it's kind of a hit.
That sounds a whole lot better.
Yeah. Yeah, it does. That sounds a whole lot better to be number two and host. But, we just got to take care of the things we can take care of. We got to worry about Friday night and prepare for Dadeville. And once that one's over, we'll see what else happened in the region.
All right. Coach Adam Fawcett, the head football coach and athletic director at B.B. Comer, after the 36-34 win over Randolph County on the road, and 2-2 in region play, 2-5 overall. And before we go, I guess practice has been maybe on a higher note this week?
Yeah, practice has been a little bit better. It's I told the guys that they're like a roller coaster. You know, we're up, 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 and then all of a sudden we're down, and then we're twisting and turning, and the woes of practice, I think, you know, and being able to make consistent changes and things like that. And And again, it goes into teenagers' lives. You know, like yesterday was e-learning day. Well, yesterday wasn't a very good practice because they weren't at school all day, you know. So
they don't tell them what's going on.
Yeah, and they're creatures of habit. So, you know, like when they're at school, you know, they got class, lunch, you know, and it kind of breaks it all down. Whereas not at school, they may have stayed up the night before. Yeah. Or they, you know, so. Before we go, I do want to give a shout out to our volleyball team. They finished runner up in the area tournament yesterday.
Great.
And they'll be headed to regionals in Montgomery next week.
All right, that's fantastic. Another successful story out of B.B. Comer High School. Coach Adam Fawcett, the head football coach, athletic director of B.B. Comer. They will take on Dadeville at the stadium, 7 o'clock kickoff on Friday night. Coach, always a pleasure. Thanks for coming.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Brought to you by Marble City Pharmacy, the Coach Adam Fawcett Show. More Daybreak coming right up.
Back at Legion Stadium in Sylacauga, you just heard from Coach Adam Fawcett, the head football coach and athletic director of B.B. Comer. And we're moments away from the kickoff of B.B. Comer and Dadeville. Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week tonight brought to you by State Representative District 33, Ben Robbins, Donahue Physical Therapy, Bailey Heating and Air, Toyota of Sylacauga, Marble City Pharmacy, Sylacauga Parks and Rec, Omnia, Heritage South Federal Credit Union, Community Funeral Home, Earlene's Florist, Stop and Shop Auto Sales, Sylacauga Glass, Bandit's Bar and Grill, and Curtis and Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg. This game tonight focused on teams jockeying for playoff position as we enter the latter part of the season. B.B. Comer and Dadeville, key region matchup tonight. And Zach, you got starting offense and defensive lineups for B.B. Comer.
Offensive starting lineup for Comer, you got at quarterback, of course, Raylan Sims. Your halfbacks are Richard Weed, Christian Jemison, and Tristan Garrett. On the line, you have Ja'Kari Brown, Josh Ruiz, Tylen Parrish, Colton Sherum, and Caden Brown. And at receivers, you have De'Arian Riley and Renato Riggins. Now for the defense, you have Richard Weed over at safety, Kamari Harris at rover, your corners Michael Kirksey and Christian Jemison. At the star, De'Arian Riley, Tristan Garrett and Raylan Sims, and on the line, Datron Wells, Josh Ruiz, Dylan Davenport, and Caden Brown.
I looked at some video of Dadeville, and you begin with their quarterback, number 5, Jay Burns. He can run and throw. He loves to throw the football. He's a senior, 6'2", 200 pounds. And running back is Brandez Eason. He's number 1. He's a junior, 6'1", 170 pounds. And Eason can catch the football. And once he catches it, he knows what to do with the football. He can also run the football. So B.B. Comer's going to have to slow these guys down tonight to have a chance to get a W tonight. Let's head down to the field for the national anthem brought to you by Sylacauga Glass. marching sound of gold under the direction of Dan Seaborn with our national anthem tonight, brought to you by Silicaga Glass. We appreciate Debbie and her staff at Silicaga Glass down on Broadway here in Silicaga. You know, the national anthem reminds us that less than, well, it'll be 2 weeks from this Tuesday, I think. Is that right? That we will have our presidential election. So a lot of happenings in our country as we get set for the presidential election coming up the first Tuesday in November. Zach, I was looking at the Dadeville schedule, and a team that they played first game of the season, a team that Silicaga plays next week here at Legion Stadium, Elmore County. Elmore County beat Dadeville in the opening game of the season 28-7. They fall to Hanley of Roanoke the following week, 48-21. They lose to Beulah, 28-14. And they lose to Randolph County, 28-0. And they lose to Realtown, 34-6. So through the first five games, they were 0-5. Their first win of the season was against Lee Scott Academy out of Auburn, 13-10. And then they come back last week, losing to Glenwood. Glenwood, top team in the region. Glenwood beats Dadeville 35-14. B.B. Calmer opened their season with a loss against Wadley right here at this same stadium. Wadley ranked number one in Class 1A, 34-6. A game that B.B. Calmer could and probably should have won against Vincent the following week. B.B. Calmer lets one get away, losing 21-18. Glenwood Academy thumps B.B. Calmer in week three, 37-14. They shut out B.B. Calmer, did Childersburg 14-0 for their first win of the season. They lose big to Piedmont the following week, 58-16. They lose a heartbreaker to Beulah, 43-40. Now remember, Beulah beat Dadeville 28-14, so some comparable scores there. And then Randolph County, B.B. Calmer beats Randolph County 36-34, and Dadeville loses to Randolph County a few weeks back 28-0. So some comparable scores there. But B.B. Calmer, if they're going to make some noise as a third or fourth seed, they got to win these region games beginning with this one tonight.
Yeah, they definitely do. Region play is the most important in all of high school football. You got to win them region games to get a playoff spot.
We're just a few moments away from the start of this one tonight from Legion Stadium. B.B. Calmer hosting Dadeville. We've got more coming up from Legion Stadium in Silicaga right after you watch this on the High School Game of the Week.
Toyota of Silicaga has you covered with exclusive VIP direct pricing. Enjoy incredible savings of up to $6,000 off the total suggested retail price on select Toyota models. Experience the thrill of driving a new or used Toyota car, truck, or SUV while keeping more money in your pocket. We don't have it on the lot. We'll find it for you. Drive home in style with VIP direct pricing at Toyota of Silicaga with up to $6,000 in total savings. ToyotaofSilicaga.com or visit us Highway 280 in Silicaga. Toyota of Silicaga. We're worth the drive.
Bandits Bar and Grill is your stop for great food, family fun, and live music. Wednesday night, it's cornhole tournament. Thursday night, biker night. Don't forget about the live music, too. Great steaks, full bar, awesome appetizers, wings, nachos, tacos, and fried catfish. Stop in today or give us a call at 256-369-2920. That's Bandits Bar and Grill on Fort Williams in Silicaga.
Welcome back to Legion Stadium, Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week. Let me mention to you about Donahue Physical Therapy. Ben and his staff do a wonderful job with physical therapy, whether you're an armchair quarterback or whether or not you are a student athlete. If your doctor prescribes physical therapy, make sure you remind your doctor that you want Donahue Physical Therapy as your physical therapist. And they're right there on West Fort Williams in Sylacauga. That's Donahue Physical Therapy. Bailey Heating and Air, you know, the seasons are changing, and that means colder weather is not on the way, but it's already here. We've had temperatures already in the 30s. So if you need that heating and cooling system service, it's Bailey Heating and Air on Highway 280. And also, Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week brought to you by State Representative District 33, Ben Robbins. Ben, one of those fantastic guys that come along maybe once or twice in a lifetime that just makes such a positive impact on his district. And he stepped into some big shoes of Ron Johnson. Ron Johnson passed away several years ago, and Ben was appointed to that District 33 position, and he won in the election and then won re-election as well. So Ben does a wonderful job. He takes care of Coosa and Talladega counties. He's State Representative District 33, Ben Robbins. You know, Zach, B.B. Comer just got a couple of games left, including this one tonight. It'll be three games, including tonight. And some of these guys, you see the captains on the B.B. Comer sideline. If they don't get some region wins, their season will be short-lived, so hopefully they can continue that winning style tonight.
Right, of course. You know, very important game again. We got the captains for both teams out there. You got number 57, Caden Brown for Comer, number 3, De'Arian Riley, and number 8, Raylan Sims. And then you got the captains for Dadeville. You got number 31, Dakari Daniels, number 71, Markevius Wilkerson, number 1, Brandon Easton, number 52, Janelan Floyd.
Dadeville down in East Alabama, right down, hop on 280 and head past Alexander City. And Dadeville, Alabama, probably about 30 miles or so away from Sylacauga. Dadeville traditionally with a very, very solid athletic program. A little off this year. They're 1-6 on the season so far, and trying to get untracked against a B.B. Comer team that is hungry for a region win tonight. And, you know, we've covered B.B. Comer, Zach, several years running where they've been deep into the playoffs every year. Now then they're scrambling to make a playoff spot.
Yeah, you know, you go 2 years making it all the way to state, and then you got this year where, you know, you lose a bunch of players to colleges, others just graduate, and then you're stuck with maybe with a few. You're stuck with a few seniors who are still great players and a lot of good underclassmen, just a little inexperienced.
B.B. Comer made the semifinals last year. The year before that, they were in the finals. And so they are accustomed to playoff football, but they've got a lot of work to do ahead of them to reach the playoffs this season. And one of the players that they depend on is Ray Sims. He's a senior, and he's the leader of this football team.
Of course he is. I mean, what can he do? He can run the ball. He can throw the ball. You put him out there at receiver, he can catch the ball. He can do everything. That's why they rely on him.
And another young man that had a great week last week catching the football is Richard Weed.
You know, week prior had that big kick return touchdown, put them up against Childersburg. And then, you know, he's just a great productor.
Dadeville won the toss. They deferred to the second half. B.B. Comer will get the football first. On a nice, nice night for high school football at Legion Stadium in Sylacauga. Of course, some big, big college football games coming up tomorrow. We'll talk about that a little bit later on as we wade into this game tonight with B.B. Comer and Dadeville. And temperatures very pleasant. You see some folks with their jackets on tonight, and for the first time in a while, we'll have temperatures in the 60s at game time. And here are the Tigers making their way on to the near sideline. Kickoff temperature around 58 degrees, so it's a little nip in the air tonight. B.B. Comer has had some injuries, and they finally have gotten their offensive line situated to where they're not shuffling everybody around, and that gives some stability to this B.B. Comer Tiger offense. So we'll see what happens tonight as B.B. Comer will get the football to begin with. The kickoff tonight brought to you by Omnia. Omnia, one of our large marble quarries in the Sylacauga area. We appreciate them partnering with us every year to bring you high school football. These student athletes are important, and we appreciate Omnia partnering with us to bring you football here on TV 47, WOIL Television. B.B. Comer out on the field now as Dable preparing to kick off. And to kick it away for Dave will be Philip Baker. B.B. Comer will probably have Richard Weed back there. That's normally who's back there to receive the kickoffs. We're just about set to go. Again, 58 degrees in downtown Sylacauga at kickoff time tonight. We welcome you aboard to the Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week as Philip Baker, the sophomore, prepares to kick it away. Omnia kickoff. Whistles blow as the kick is made, and not a whole lot of running room for Christian Jemison, the sophomore.
Brought down early by the Tiger defense.
Thought I heard whistles blowing as the kick was in the air, but apparently not. So B.B. Comer will take over at their own 19-yard line with a first and 10. And you know that Dadeville is going to be keying on Raylion Sims. And Sims will take the snap. And he keeps it himself, and he stood up and thrown back for a loss.
Great stuff behind the line. That's number 51, Dayton Lankard, and number 52, Janelan Floyd. Not allowing Raylan Sims to go anywhere.
So a loss of two, so second and 12. Just underway, second down and 12. Sims loads to throw. Plenty of time. Now rolls away from pressure. He's trying to get on the corner. Little stutter step, and he's hit and falls forward to about the 23-yard line, make it the 21-yard line before whistles blow, and they're going to spot it right around the 20-yard line.
Sims does a good job of getting away from pressure, sees that nobody's open, breaks a tackle or two. But this Dadeville defense is showing that they don't have many weaknesses.
So third down and long, third and nine. Sims looking to throw. Gets away from pressure, now pulls it down, breaks a couple of tackles. He's across the 25, fumbles a football. Dadeville says they have it. I think they do. It's a 29-yard line. They strip Sims of the football and fall on it, and Dayton will have the first turnover of the night.
You know, he was making good progress too. It was a good run. Just had a bunch of guys on him, and then finally took one person and stripped the ball from him.
So Dayton will take over on the turnover. It'll be first and 10. And again, Jay Burns, he'll have Eason back there with him. along with Childers. Burns swings out of the backfield to Eason. Eason reverses his steps, and he slips one tackle. But
great tackle.
Yeah, it was about the 31-yard line before he stripped up.
That's Richard Weed.
And Weed needed to make that tackle because he had some running room.
He did. Great open field tackle.
So a loss of 2, second and 12.
It would be great for this Colmar defense to get a stop right here, maybe put a spark into the offense.
Four-man Tiger front. Burns looks to throw. He's going down the middle of the field. He's got some time. Now pumps and throws into single coverage. And it is incomplete. Great defensive play by the Tigers.
It was a great ball, too. But then, you know, Michael Kirksey uses his height and good DB skills to get back there and prevent the completion.
Intended for McKelvey, Davis McKelvey, the sophomore. So it'll bring up third down and 12.
And great ball by Eason. Put it right in the bed basket.
Eason getting the play from the sideline. We're just underway at Legion Stadium. B.B. Colmar, the opening drive, fumble. Dable recovered.
Now you got Jay Burns in there, quarterback.
Burns is a good one. He'll take the snap, keep it himself, whistles blow. Penalty flag is down. False start against the Tigers. So back it up 5 yards. Burns, the starting quarterback, he's a senior, 6'2", 200 pounds, so he's a big quarterback. So it's at the 36-yard line. They've got to get just close to the 19 for a first down. B.B. Colmar doesn't want to give up anything deep here. Third and very long. Pressure coming. Burns fires. Is caught inside the 20. And slipping a tackle. See where they're spotted right around the 20-yard line. It'd be maybe a half yard shy of the first down. That was a nice throw and catch.
It was. Get him out of a bind a little bit.
Fourth and a yard. Wouldn't be surprised to see the football in Eason's hand, number one. And the quarterback keeps. It's a first down and more. Pushing inside the 15 to about the 13 goes quarterback Jay Burns.
Finally brought down by number 55. You're going to have to – that's Ja'Kari Brown's going to have to come out of the game. His helmet came off.
In the red zone now at the 13-yard line. Again, pushing the pile to about the 7-yard line is Burns. So about the 7-yard line. Here is Dadeville back to the line of scrimmage. Big hole off the left side, but B.B. Colmar, Zach, closes it up in a hurry.
They do. That's number 57, Caden Brown, getting back there.
Looked like there was running room for Jefferson, but B.B. Colmar closed it up in a hurry. So third down. Got to get to about the 3 for a first down. Burns could run and throw. He takes a snap. He's trying to get on the corner. Penalty flag's down. He'll step into the end zone, but that may be a holding call on Dadeville.
probably going to be on number 52, Janelin Floyd.
So the touchdown is wiped off the board. That'll be a 10-yard penalty against the Dayton Tigers. It'll be placed down at about the 18-yard line. So still got to get to about the 3, but they faced long yardage already on this drive and converted, so let's see what happens here. Quarterback Jay Burns out of the spread formation. Trying to keep it himself.
Good
play.
He's
racing to the end zone.
He's
untouched
gone.
For the touchdown. My goodness. Burns.
Great ball fake.
Wow. B.B. Culver not looking for that, apparently. So a turnover, a fumble recovery by Dadeville. They convert on a couple of third and longs, and they take the lead 6-0.
Brady Knox in to kick the extra point. And they almost got back there.
Yeah, but the kick has been good. So 7:31 to go in the first quarter. It's Dadeville 7, B.B. Culver nothing. Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week. We'll be back right after this.
If you listen carefully, you'll hear the roads of Alabama calling. And Sarah Honda has your answer during our Honda Summer Event. Serving you for over 40 years with a great selection of Honda and pre-owned inventories and the Sarah Promise. Take home a new 2024 Honda Accord for $259 a month for 36 months. Or a 2024 Honda HR-V for $269 for 36 months. Or receive a loyalty offer of up to $750 on a new Honda CR-V. Alabama can be yours to discover in a new vehicle from Sarah Honda in Sylacauga.
Dadeville recovering a B.B. Culver fumble and convert on a couple of third and longs. I can take the lead 7-0.
You know, they drove down the field. Not really. They had good position, but for what they had, they made do.
So B.B. Culver will receive the kickoff from Philip Baker. Baker's a sophomore, 5'9", 145 pounds. Tigers got to protect the football better as Sims had it stripped from him earlier in the quarter and it cost the Tigers. Baker drives it down the field, taking it to the 10-yard line, bobbled and picks up. And across the 25 to the 27-yard line goes Riley.
Brought down by a number 24, Kale Hanks, and number 31, Dakari Daniels.
So it'll be a first down for B.B. Culver at the 27-yard line, trailing 7-0. Sims, a senior, takes the snap. Hands it off left end, down the sideline,
he's
across
got
the 40,
room.
45 to the 48-yard line. Nice run by Tristan Garrett.
Finally brought down by number 11, Kyle Moss.
Garrett had a lot of running room out to the 43-yard line. Six-man front showing for Dadeville. Blow that one up pretty good. Getting to the 45 is Garrett.
Brought down by the Dadeville defensive line.
Pick up of a yard, second and 9. Dadeville leading B.B. Culver 7-0. And B.B. Comer going to be penalized, and there was some mix-up on the snap cadence, and that's going to cost B.B. Comer 5 yards. So, Zach, when this is going on, you know, you got your linemen down, and sometimes that they either don't hear it or mishear it or something like that.
Right, they get the call wrong, something like that.
After the penalty, your Sims three-step to throw, throws it behind the intended receiver, incomplete.
Intended for Richard Weed. Cordae Jefferson was there on the coverage.
Third down and about 15, maybe 14. B.B. Comer trailing in this one, 7-0. Sims being pressured, now steps up in the pocket. He's going to break a tackle, and he can move once he gets in the middle of the field. He runs it out to the 48-yard line. He'll be about 4 yards short of the first down.
Finally brought down by Davis McKelvey, but great run by Sims.
Wouldn't be surprised to see B.B. Comer go for it here on a 4th and 5. It looks like they are. Trailing 7-0, and the clock running down. Sims to throw it. He rolls away from pressure. He's in trouble. He's throwing the home run ball, and that's going to be incomplete. And a nice job defensively by Hurd not to intercept it because he had lost yardage. But
that's a smart
move. Dave was going to get it back up here near midfield or thereabouts.
Smart move by Cam Hurd.
That play didn't look good from the start. So at the 48-yard line, David will take over, leading 7-0. 4:32 to go in the first quarter.
They've shown, Comer has shown they have a little bit of fight in them driving downfield like that.
Yeah.
But let's see if they can get it back on defense.
Burns takes a snap and hands off to the dangerous Eason. Eason's on the corner. Eason's got blinding speed. You got one man to beat and pushed out of bounds at about the 12-yard line, making the 17-yard line.
Tried to hurdle him.
Down two, and that may be against B.B. Comer.
Tried to hurdle Christian Jemison. Jemison just pushes him out of bounds.
Here's the referee. Flag was thrown after the play, so let's see. Personal foul against Dade. Wow, that's good for B.B. Comer.
That'll tack off a lot of yardage.
Yes, sir. And you usually see that go against the defense, but apparently Eason said something. That'll bring it all the way back out to the 33-yard line. Big break for the Tigers. It's called a personal foul. I don't know if Eason said something or did something, but whistles blow again. And I think the officials want to talk this over and see if they got the ball set correctly. Got to move the chains. If the chains aren't set, now then they'll move them. So, after the unsportsmanlike penalty call against Dadeville at the 33-yard line, they've got to get to about the 20. 4 for a first down. Low snap. Burns picks it up, and B.B. Comer slams him down.
Great job to get back there. Tackled by number 55, Ja'Kari Brown. And many others. Number 57, Caden Brown.
The Brown brothers, I guess. Under 4 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Curtis and Son Funeral Home first quarter. Davis 7, B.B. Comer nothing. Comer's defensive front stepping up, looking to throw it out of the backfield. Caught by Hurd, and Hurd circles left in, and he's going to be close to the first down at the 25.
Finally brought down by number 3, De'Arian Riley, and number 11, Michael Kirkson.
So, Zach, time after time, Dadeville makes a big play with second or third and long.
You know, you just got to – you get them big plays, but don't get penalties. They'll bring you back.
Third and two. B.B. Comer may have jumped offside. That is indeed the call against the Tigers.
That's going to be on number 55, Ja'Kari Brown.
That'd be Earlene Flores' first down. For the Dadeville Tigers at the B.B. Comer 20-yard line. So first and 10 once again. Burns with Easton back there with him. Burns keeps it. Burns
got running
down
room
the sideline.
He's got good tackle.
Near the goal line, right outside the goal line, inside the one. It'll be first and goal.
Great run, but great tackle by Michael Kirksey, stopping a touchdown.
Earlene's Flores' first down for Jay Burns, the senior. And, you know, Kirksey's he's not that big a guy, but
sure ain't afraid of contact.
Down.
Sure ain't afraid of contact.
Yep. So first and goal, just inside the 1 yard line. Pushing forward is
he's got it.
Jefferson, and they show him short of the touchdown. So it'll be second and goal. Boy, that looked like he was in the end zone.
It did, by a mile.
But they mark it actually about a half a yard loss. So second and goal. Burns, the quarterback. B.B. Comer digging in defensively. This time Burns keeps his heavy. He's hit short again.
Great tackle.
Sims, isn't it? Yeah.
It's Raylan Sims.
So third and goal at the one.
This would be huge for Comer if they could get a goal line stand right here.
You're right. 90 seconds to go in the first quarter. Dadeville 7, B.B. Comer nothing. Third and a full yard to go. Burns pitches. And not
and he's
going
got
anywhere. He's going to lose yardage back at the 5 yard line.
Great job by this Comer defense. Raylan Sims is fired up.
So bring up fourth down now, and they were just inches away from the goal line.
Right.
Now it's fourth and goal at the 5.
All this caused by an extra effort by Michael Kirksey to make sure he does not score and stops him short of the goal line.
And he was the only one there to make the tackle.
He was.
B.B. Comer crowd is livened up a little bit. Try to get a goal line stand here, and it would be certainly that. Going to have to get a timeout here because the play clock's going to run down, and there's plenty of time still left in the first quarter. So Dadeville takes a timeout. And leading by a score of 7-0. And Zach, what does this mean if B.B. Comer is able to keep them out of the end zone?
Yeah, if they're able to get a stop right here, it means they get the ball back, they get the drive down the field, you know, with a spark in the offense, possibly score and tie this football game up. You can't allow Dadeville to score again, or else, you know, huge morale loss, and that'll just boost them up higher.
You know, and Kirksey was the last man standing for B.B. Comer on that long run.
He was. I mean, that is a game-changing tackle even.
So fourth down and goal at the 5-yard line, and think about Burns, he can run or throw. So you got to be careful here.
I mean, you got to suspect they're going to throw the ball.
So fourth down and goal from the B.B. Comer 5-yard line. Dadeville kind of late getting back out on the field. Referee clapping his hands saying, hey, let's go. Coach Fawcett getting the crowd pumped up. Fourth down and goal. Senior quarterback Jay Burns with junior Brandez Eason back there with him. Fourth and goal, rolling to throw, looking, in trouble. He's going to have to throw it in a hurry, and it is incomplete. B.B. Comer holds.
Great stop by this Comer defense. They sure know how to not give up.
So the Tigers take over, and on the first down, Dable was just inches short of the goal line.
Yep.
And the Tiger defense stands tall, shuts them down, and takes over at their own 5-yard line.
For Dadeville, that was one of the kind of a one-route play. They assumed that he was going to get open on that corner route, but no, it was just great defense and a great goal line stand by this Comer defense.
Here's Sims handing to his running back, who's in trouble, and he doesn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Great defensive play by the Dadeville Tigers.
Brought down by number 54, Gabe Abernathy.
That's the end of the first quarter as Tristan Garrett fortunate to get back to the line of scrimmage. First quarter is complete. Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week. Dadeville 7, B.B. Comer nothing. Back with more after this.
The all-new Marble City Pharmacy in Sylacauga is your destination for the highest quality health care. Our remodeled and expanded pharmacy gives us the space to serve more patients. We've added a drive-through window for those times when you don't feel like getting out of your vehicle. And we still offer delivery within city limits. We feature a full line of over-the-counter medications and supplements. And don't forget our stunning new gift department. New building, same great people. Marble City Pharmacy, here for life.
A goal line stand by B.B. Comer's defense keeps Dadeville. You talk about, Zach, not allowing Dadeville to score again. They're already up 7-0, and it would have been difficult if B.B. Comer go down two scores. But that defensive stand says a lot for this Tiger club.
It does. It shows, you know, no quit. No quit at all. And they know how to go out there, and they know how to give their best.
Coach Fawcett talking to his football team, a rather young team, not a whole lot of seniors. And they're coming back out on the field with a second down and 11 from their own 4-yard line. Got to protect the football. And first down to be real nice here for the Tigers. Sims will take the snap at his goal line. He's going to try to throw it. He's in trouble. Rolls away in the back of the end zone, throwing, and is incomplete.
Nobody in the general direction. Just want to make sure he didn't get a safety.
So third down and 11. So Dadeville putting pressure on the Tigers' offense. B.B. Comer sends in Christian Jemison. And also Ronaldo Riggins. So third and 11 from the 4 yard line. Sims in trouble, pulls it down. Sims races across the 10. He's got running room, 20, 25, 30, and tackled down, spun down at the 28 yard line. What a great run by Sims.
Fantastic job to get out of pressure. Turn nothing into something. Great run by Sims. Finally brought down by Davis McKelvey.
All the way out to the 29-yard line. So a 25-yard run by Sims. That's a huge Earlene's Flores first down. Sims whips it through behind the intended receiver. The receiver went inside. The pass went outside, intended for Riley. I think Riley went the wrong way.
As said by Coach Fossil.
Yeah, kind of giving him an earful. Second down and 10. Pull it down. 35 face mask penalty probably coming right there.
That'll be on Jay Burns, if that's the call.
So Sims doing a lot of it on his own here for B.B. Colmer. .10:41 in the first half. B.B. Colmer trailing 7-0. And let's see, holding against B.B. Colmer. Wow. Oh, my goodness.
It's not what they were expecting.
I didn't see a Tiger player over there except the quarterback, but that's a big, big penalty. So back at the 20-yard line now.
I thought for sure they were going to call face mask.
Dadeville calls a timeout with 10:36 to go in the first half. Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week brought to you by Heritage South Federal Credit Union. And, you know, they got their big car sale going on right now, and it goes through tomorrow. And that's a big deal. A lot of vehicles out on Highway 280, and Heritage South Federal Credit Union sponsors this a couple of times a year. So remember that on Saturday. Also, Community Funeral Home, Charles Woods and Cadero Wood at Community Funeral Home. Pre-need to at-need funeral services, funerals, burials, or cremation. 511 Edgewood Drive in Sylacauga. It is Community Funeral Home. Cadero Woods is the vice president, and Charles Woods, the owner and president of the company. That is Community Funeral Home. Pre-need, at-need funeral services, funerals, burials, or cremation. You see Coach Fawcett exhorting his team about that holding call, and he's not pleased with that at all.
Definitely not, you know. You put together a good drive, and then you get something like that. Doesn't end it, but it sure starts the start of it.
So Dade will call the timeout, so give B.B. Colmer a little chance to catch their breath and regroup a little bit. Trailing 7-0, Sims looking to throw it. He's in trouble again. He's on the run, throws on the run, caught out
great
here
ball
at the 40-yard line. Great throw and catch to Riley.
Finally brought down by Cam Hurd, but a great gain for the Tigers.
Earlene's Flores first down at the 40-yard line. You know, they had tried to connect several times, and he had thrown behind the intended receiver. And coaching staff thinking Riley may have been running the wrong route, but he run that one well.
Good move.
Face mask penalty might come right here. I saw the head turn to one side. The running back is Garrett. Let's see.
Garrett made a quick move to get back inside, but was quickly shut down afterwards.
There's a face mask, maybe a 5-yard mark off there. Let's see. It's going to be 15 yards. So, it's a big play for BB Cone. Remember, they started at their own 4-yard line. They're now out to the 45.
Right. And if you're Comer, you want to get down there and score, but you also want to take off as much time as you can.
Mm-hmm. Sims got plenty of time now. Throws a home run ball. And it's too long for the intended receiver at the 15-yard line. Looked like the receiver kind of slowed down a little bit.
You know, in the game against Childersburg, it always seemed like the receivers were getting open, but just, you know, would be holding against the Comer offense.
Wouldn't have mattered anyway. A lot of yellow hankies on the ground tonight. So back to the 35-yard line. Talking to one of the other officials, and got the ball spotted at the 35-yard line. First down. Sims. Throws it away. Nearest man to it was Fair, the sophomore. So second down and a quarter of a mile. They got to get all the way to near midfield. Coach Adam Fawcett, head football coach and athletic director at BB Comer, trying to get this Tiger team going the right direction after some rough sledding so far in the season. They lost a lot of players off that last year's team, a semifinal run in Class 2A. And again, whistles blow, another penalty. False start against BB Comer. Let's see if we can get two plays running in succession without a penalty.
Maybe. Maybe we'll get there.
9:20 in the first half. Dadeville 7, BB Comer nothing. And a little kind of a sloppy second quarter by both teams.
Penalties have hurt both.
Senior Raylon Sims. Sending a man in motion. He
steps
pulls
up.
It down. Everybody watch it. Throws it across the field.
Good ball.
At midfield.
Golly.
I don't think he was intended receiver there, but one of the up men was Jemison. But Jemison didn't catch it.
It was Richard Weed.
Yeah. That's Earlene Flores' first down at midfield. Now, that was a strong throw by Sims.
Patient as well. He saw two receivers in the area and threw it. Didn't really have a choice.
He threw it across his body, but it got there for a Tiger first down. BB Comer may have moved again.
Penalties have really hurt him.
So Josh Ruiz, I believe the sophomore. Tigers having all kind of problems. Their offensive line. Holdings and false starts. Now they got trips receivers to the bottom of the screen. Rolling out of the pocket now, winding up and throwing. It looks like it may be intercepted. Nope, incomplete, the official says. He's trying to get it to Jemison. But,
and Comer.
Incomplete.
Comer catches a break right there.
At the 45-yard line, second down and very long. It's been the arm of Sims that's got the Tigers out from their own goal line. He winds up and lets it go again. It's incomplete. Another penalty flag is down.
The receiver is
Riley, but that's going to be interference probably against McKelvey. So that'll give the Tigers a first down.
It will, and you know, penalties are hurting them and you know, helping them.
You know, I was looking at Dadeville's defensive front. They appeared already to be very tired. Mm-hmm. They're not putting the pressure on Sims like they were in the first quarter.
You know, they're being wore out. They're having pretty much every play to chase him to the outside. And you're just not going to catch him.
40-yard line, first and 10 for the Tigers. Trailing 7-0, 8 minutes to go in the first half. See Dadeville's defensive linemen with their hands on their hips. That's usually a sign, man, I need a breather. And whistles blow again. We got a replacement coming in. That's Justin Young. I had an injured player limp off to the sideline. Out of the spread is Sims. Coming after him. Sims in trouble. Now he pulls it down again.
My goodness.
Tackle. There he goes. Look at Sims all the way to the 22-yard line. What a great run by Raylon Sims.
And what a great player. I mean, he does the extra effort. He can get through tackles any day, weave through defenders. Finally tackled down by number 11, Kai Moss.
He had to break four or five tackles in.
Mm-hmm.
So Orleans Flores first down for B.B. Culver at the Dadeville 22-yard line, trailing 7-0. Two-step drop, Sims rolling, throwing it away. Second down.
And that could be, you know, that could be the key to if Culver scores.
If call a penalty on that. Yep.
Threw it a little late.
I would say so. They got a legal grounding on Sims, and they're probably right, but they're kind of late throwing the flag. My goodness, we've had a lot of laundry flying. Loss of down, too.
If you're Comer, you're really just trying to wear this Dadeville defense, wear them down.
And you can see Dadeville's not putting the pressure on him that they were.
Yeah, right. You need to get them tired so in the second half, that's when you can let loose. And B.B. Comer has had the ball, it feels like, the whole second quarter.
Yeah, Sims has got to have some help from some of his other players here. He drops back to throw, and he's in trouble. Pulls it down again, breaking tackles.
Goodness.
Inside the 40 to about the 37-yard line.
Just can't seem to bring
him
down.
You, Dadeville's defensive front is struggling.
They really are.
But we're going to have to get the injured player for Dadeville out of the game. That's Janelan Floyd, 230-pounder. He limps off. The Tigers got to get all the way down to the 22-yard line long way to go on third down. Actually, got to get back, golly, all the way down to the 12. That's at least a mile and a half. Goodness. .644 to go in the first half.
Throws it deep.
Incomplete.
Oh.
So fourth down.
It's always just a yard or two too far for the intended receiver.
We'll punt this one away as they'll bring in Seth Pettit, the senior punter. And you're right, B.B. Comer, it just feels like they've had the football the whole second quarter.
I mean, you could say a fantastic drive just wasted, really.
And you've got people like Raylon Sims. We talked about Dadeville being tired. Sims has got to be worn out. Mm-hmm. And another penalty flag is down. False start against B.B. Comer. Mark off another 5 yards. At the 42-yard line. Nice punt by Pettit. It's going to bounce laterally and it'll go inside the 10-yard line and roll all the way to the 6. Good punt by Seth Pettit.
Comer.
So with 6:11 to go in the first half, Dadeville 7, B.B. Comer nothing. Zach, if you're Dadeville, you know, you're up 7-0, you kind of feel like you're behind.
Right. You know, Comer, they've had great drive. They've had a great drive. But the flags are killing them. I mean, from holding calls, you know,
false starts.
They get that big face mask call, the big pass interference brings them halfway down the field, and then you just have to punt the ball away.
All right, first and 10 for Dadeville from their 7. Looking to throw it, throws out of bounds, incomplete. Double coverage, B.B. Comer. Jay Burns with a 2nd and 10. Neither football team outside of that goal line stand by B.B. Comer has really done anything worth mentioning a whole lot so far. Eason, he's dangerous.
He gets the outside.
All the way across the 35 to the 37-yard line. B.B. Comer had a shot at him in the backfield but didn't get him.
Mm-hmm. Had a great fake from the quarterback to the running back. Finally brought down by number 4, Christian Jemison.
That's Earlene's Flores' first down up here at the 37-yard line. So David with some breathing room here. Natron Wells holding his right hand like he's hurt. And the Tigers miss a couple of tackles, and on the run is Burns out near midfield. Move the chains, and Earlene's Flores first down.
He's brought down by, let's see, Tristan Garrett and Richard Weed. Michael Kirksey also in there.
So a first down for Dadeville at midfield, leading 7-0 with 4:48. You know Dadeville would love to take this on into the end zone.
They really would. You know, just to really put the icing on the cake for the first half at least. And you could consider it a successful half. Gets it back inside.
That is Jefferson on the carry. Got 2 yards, and that's about all.
Good open field tackle there by Richard Weed. had at least 10 yards of green grass ahead of him.
They'll bring back Eason in at halfback. Eason, 6'1", 170 pounds. He's a good player. I saw a lot of tape of him and quarterback Burns the last few weeks. So second and 8. Burns with a little reverse to Hurd. Hurd turns a corner and didn't get a whole lot. Great recovery by the Tigers defensively.
Richard Reed gets to the outside, so the runner has to cut back inside and finally brought down by Tristan Garrett.
About 4 yards short of the first down.
Again, if Comer can stop them from scoring on this drive, that would be huge.
3:15, the clock counting. Third down for Dave on about 4. Quarterback keeps. B.B. Comer hits him, and he falls forward for the first down. That's Burns on the carry.
Patreon Wells as well as Caden Brown.
You know, B.B. Comer's defensive front making good penetration, but just can't close the deal. So under 3 minutes to go. Dadeville at the Tiger 40-yard line. That's Eason. Eason's got the corner. Eason's got the touchdown. Brandez Eason from 40 yards out for the Dadeville touchdown. It's 13-0.
And just nobody's going to catch him. When he reaches that outside, you can pretty much say bye.
They said bye from behind.
They did.
So it's now 13-0, and B.B. Comer could ill afford to give up that touchdown. After seemingly had a drive of themselves going deep in Dadeville territory, and penalties just killed the drive. I don't know if they call a penalty on this play or not. I think they have. Wipe that off the board.
That would be huge for Comer.
Well, let's see what it is. Referee's over talking to Coach Fawcett. And let's see. Here we go. Personal foul against Dadeville. So they'll mark it off after the touchdown. So on the kickoff, they'll mark the penalty off against the Dadeville Tigers. So it's still 13-0 with a point after to follow. Happened after the touchdown, personal foul. 2:24 to go in the first half. Dadeville 13, B.B. Comer nothing. How big is that goal line stand now?
Oh, it was, you know, you got to not let them score on every drive, which that big goal line stand down there, yeah. That was everything to them.
Point after from Philip Baker. And this is a different, this is Brady Knox kicking now. Knox kind of.
Whoa.
But it went. Oh,
didn't see that.
It was good. So with. 2:24 to go in the first half. Dadeville 14, B.B. Comer nothing. Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week continues in a minute.
Omnia Inc. is a leading global producer of calcium carbonate and a worldwide distributor of specialty chemicals. Omnia has an unwavering commitment to quality and total customer satisfaction through leadership in manufacturing technology, product innovation, application expertise, incomparable service, and an exceptional understanding of our customers' needs. Omnia takes pride in continuous direct customer communications to understand their changing needs for new product development and logistical support. Omnia Inc. is pleased to have been a part of the Sylacauga and surrounding communities since 1992.
If you listen carefully, you'll hear the roads of Alabama calling. Tony Sarah Ford has your answer. We offer a great selection of Ford and pre-owned inventories and the Sarah Promise. During our Make It Ford Summer Sales event, take home a 2023 F-150 with 1.9% APR or up to $6,000 in bonus cash. Or a new Expedition with 0% APR and $1,000 bonus cash, plus no payments for 90 days. Alabama can be yours to discover in a new vehicle from Tony Sarah Ford in Sylacauga.
Some of the fans yelling from the stands, come on, B.B. Comer, play football.
You know.
They're down 14 to nothing. Dadeville kicks it off, leading by two scores. We near halftime, 2:24 to go. Caught at the 27.
They're going to have great field position.
Yeah.
Right at the 50.
So good starting point for B.B. Comer, trailing 14 to nothing. The kickoff return by Richard Weed.
Finally pushed out of bounds by number two, Cam Hurd.
So let's see if B.B. Comer can get on the board. At midfield, trailing by two scores. This is a game B.B. Comer must win if they're to have any hope for playoffs. Sims hands off to Garrett, who stutter steps, and he's got a yard.
Brought down at the line of scrimmage.
Second and very long, second and nine. We're under 2 minutes to go in the first half. B.B. Comer quickly to the line of scrimmage. Tristan Garrett lines up with Sims. Flings it, just dropped by Richard Weed, and I think Weed turned to run before he caught the football.
Mm-hmm. But if he'd have caught it and tried to catch it, could have been worse.
Yeah. Third and nine. He had some Dadeville Tigers breathing down his neck. Minute 28 in the half. Dadeville up two scores. Don't forget, we've got our halftime show coming up, brought to you by Coosa Valley Medical Center. Sims dances
Goodness.
Down the sideline, and he is pushed out of bounds at the 40-yard line. The clock keeps moving, and he may be a yard short of the first down.
But, man, does he know how to get out of trouble.
Third and a yard, the clock moving, a minute 10 to go in the half. Comer doesn't seem to be any big hurry, but you're going to have to move it pretty quickly. My goodness, they're burning a lot of clock. Sims not going
get back
there
instantly.
He
and
lost
he fumbled.
The football, and Dadeville falls on it. Dadeville's going to take over. And Sims limping off the field. And Coach Fawcett kind of chastising his offensive line because they couldn't get a yard, and Dadeville recovers the fumble, and they've got it at their 42-yard line with 36 seconds to go. Don't think about Dadeville just going to sit on it. They may try to get more points. Here is Jay Burns. He's got the speedster Eason back there with him. Three-man Tiger front. Here's Eason off right in. Eason's got running room. Eason's pushed out of bounds at the Tiger 43. Stops the clock with 28 seconds to go into half.
Tristan Garrett there to make the stop.
Erlene's floor is first down. They move the chains once again. So Dable is capable of quickly moving the football with either Burns or Eason. Burns throwing deep, got a man open, and penalty is going to be called against B.B. Colmer. And Michael Kirksey was beaten on the play, and he was trying to recover. McKelvey was pushed off, and that'll be against the Tigers. That was pretty obvious.
It was. Had a clear path to the football, little underthrown. Still, Kirksey has to know when to push and when to not.
That'll be a 15-yard mark off. Inside the 30 to the 27-yard line. Just 19 seconds to go. B.B. Colmer will be fortunate if they can keep him out of the end zone here. Not been a good half of football for B.B. Colmer. Outside of that goal line stand. Triple coverage, incomplete, with 12 seconds to go. You know, the receiver almost circled around and caught that ball.
Yeah, I thought he was going to.
Second down and 10. Only 12 seconds remain in the half. Burns has got three receivers to the near side, one to the top. Burns going to keep it. Burns inside the 20, inside the 10, 5, touchdown. My goodness.
And that's exactly what B.B. Colmer didn't want.
Jay Burns puts another touchdown on the board, and it's 20-0. Went right straight up the middle. Point after to follow. Again, it's Brady Knox, the junior, to kick it. Place down, kick up, and the kick is true. With 4 seconds to go in the first half, it is Dable 21 and B.B. Colmer nothing. And Zach, Coach Fawcett's got to be beside himself because this has just been not a real good showing in the first half for the Tigers.
Yeah, really not. You know, you're getting a lot of flags. You can't have it. You know, a lot of penalties, a lot of mental mistakes.
Fumbled the football at the Dable 42, and it takes them hardly any time to get in the end zone. And Dable has won one game this year.
Right. And Raylan Sims, you know, he's putting on a show for what he can.
Yeah.
But he's been the one who's fumbled two times, but also at the same time you got to expect more from your O-line. He's getting hit by multiple guys at the same time. It's kind of hard to hold on to the football.
And he limped off the field after that last fumble. Hope he's okay. So at the 40-yard line, Dave will kick off and. I don't think I'd want to be in B.B. Comer's dressing room at halftime.
I wouldn't either.
Philip Baker to kick off. And a squib kick that's caught and falling on it at about the 37-yard line. And the first half has come to a close. B.B. Colmer shocked 21 to nothing. And the clock is showing no time left. And let's see if they're going to give him a play here.
I think he might have got down with 2 to 3 seconds left.
Maybe so. Showing, yeah.
0.8.
Now, Dave wants to call a timeout. And I guess they just want to make sure B.B. Colmer don't try some razzle-dazzle and get behind him. But Coach Fawcett, you know, he got a haircut. Because he was on the show yesterday and his hair was longer and he may have pulled it out tonight. I'm not sure. B.B. Colmer is in trouble for sure, trailing 21 to nothing as we head to the end of the first half. And we do have a quarterback change. It is Max Fawcett, the sophomore, in for Sims. And that's not good news for B.B. Colmer with your best all-around player on the sideline. Maybe he can come back in the second half. Let's see.
Or you can trust Max Fawcett to step up in a big moment.
Max Young, he hadn't had a whole lot of playing time. First half coming to a close, and B.B. Colmer will go to the dressing room trailing by a score of 21 to nothing. The Dadeville Tigers over B.B. Colmer. We've got our halftime show coming up next. Don't go away. This is Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week.
If you listen carefully, you'll hear the roads of Alabama calling. Tony Sarah Ford has your answer. We offer a great selection of Ford and pre-owned inventories and the Sarah Promise. During our Make It Ford Summer Sales event, take home a 2023 F-150 with 1.9% APR or up to $6,000 in bonus cash. Or a new Expedition with 0% APR and $1,000 bonus cash, plus no payments for 90 days. Alabama can be yours to discover in a new vehicle from Tony Sarah Ford in Sylacauga.
Heritage South Credit Union proudly serves the cities of Sylacauga, Childersburg, Moody, and surrounding counties. Unlike regular banks, Heritage South Credit Union is member-owned. And with over 13,000 members, Heritage South Credit Union is the premier financial institution in the markets they serve. Visit them online at myhscu.com. Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union for over 80 years. Federally insured by the NCUA.
A funeral service represents a family's final farewell to their loved ones. Knowing this, we go beyond what is expected to ensure the ceremony is beautiful and memorable, a truly fitting tribute to that special life. We invite you to visit us to meet our staff and tour our renovated facility complete with a new dining area and catering services. We've been serving the people of this area for over 40 years, and we think that you'll be pleased to find that making lasting impressions remains our first priority. Curtis & Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg.
Donna! Thank you.
A funeral service represents a family's final farewell to their loved ones. Knowing this, we go beyond what is expected to ensure the ceremony is beautiful and memorable, a truly fitting tribute to that special life. We invite you to visit us to meet our staff and tour our renovated facility complete with a new dining area and catering services. We've been serving the people of this area for over 40 years, and we think that you'll be pleased to find that making lasting impressions remains our first priority. Curtis & Son Funeral Home, Sylacauga, Childersburg.
Maxi VZ Senior Center is buzzing with activities. Seniors ages 55 and up are invited to join in all the fun. Enjoy free activities like chair Zumba, sewing, quilting, ceramics, pickleball, games, and more. Our complete calendar of events can be found on our Facebook page and our website at sylacauga.recdesk.com. The Senior Center is located at 2 West 8th Street in Sylacauga and is open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Come see us.
On behalf of the Talladega County Board of Education, Superintendent Dr. Suzanne Lacey, B.B. Comer High School Principal Jamie Danford, Assistant Principal Chris Johnson, and Band Director Ann Singer, we proudly present the marching sound of gold. Band is under the field direction of drum major Emily Robinson, color captain for Mexico.
Thank you. Toyota of Sylacauga has you covered with exclusive VIP direct pricing. Enjoy incredible savings of up to $6,000 off the total suggested retail price on select Toyota models. Experience the thrill of driving a new or used Toyota car, truck, or SUV while keeping more money in your pocket. We don't have it on the lot. We'll find it for you. Drive home in style with VIP direct pricing at Toyota of Sylacauga with up to $6,000 in total savings. ToyotaofSylacauga.com or visit us Highway 280 in Sylacauga. Toyota of Sylacauga. We're worth the drive.
Bandits Bar and Grill is your stop for great food, family fun, and live music. Wednesday night, it's cornhole tournament. Thursday night, biker night. Don't forget about the live music, too. Great steaks, full bar, awesome appetizers, wings, nachos, tacos, and fried catfish. Stop in today or give us a call at 256-369-2920. That's Bandits Bar and Grill on Fort Williams in Sylacauga.
Back at Legion Stadium in Sylacauga, Jim Adell along with Zach. It's 21-0 Dadeville over B.B. Culver. And Zach, we talked about in the second quarter pretty early on how important that goal line stand was by B.B. Culver. But boy, that's become second fiddle now as Dadeville's opened up a 3-touchdown lead.
Right, you know, but I feel like the game is a lot more closer than the score reads. I feel like Comer's put up a fight, but they have been knocked back by penalties and things like that. But I'm not saying they haven't put their heart and soul into this game and they haven't put together at least one or two good drives.
Two fumbles by quarterback Raylon Sims and led to touchdowns.
But, you know, that reflects on the O-line as well. You got to hold on to the football, but you got to block for the person who's holding the football.
B.B. Comer's had all kinds of problems with their offensive and defensive lines. As they had penalty after penalty, holdings, false starts, and just had, was especially the second quarter, just was not a good second quarter by B.B. Comer standards. And you got to give Daveville some credit. They've got a good football team with Burns at quarterback and Eason, the running back, which we talked about early on.
Right. You know, he's busted off a few good plays. Had that touchdown run before the half ended. And they know how to move the football for sure.
Question's going to be if Sims is able to come back for B.B. Comer, because he didn't come in on that last drive, and
so
he limped off the field late in the half after that second fumble. So let's see if he's able to come back.
Yeah, it's either going to be him or, you know, the sophomore, Max Fawcett.
So Coach Adam Fawcett with his football team about to come back to the sideline, and I'm sure that they had a nice chat at halftime. B.B. Comer trailing 21-0 in a game that's so important in region play, and B.B. Comer's going to have to get it going. Daveville gets the football to begin the third quarter.
There he is, the man who's done just about all the work for B.B. Comer so far. He's done great of getting out of sacks, getting out of the pressure, and he's made a lot out of nothing and turned it into something.
And you can obviously tell he's limping, favoring an ankle. And let's see if he's able to come back. B.B. Comer will kick off to begin the third quarter, trailing 21-0, and they can ill afford to give up anything else.
Right.
Sarah Automotive High School game of the week. Halftime show brought to you by Coosa Valley Medical Center. Third quarter action. Donahue Physical Therapy on West Fort Williams in Sylacauga. B.B. Comer kicking off.
Little squib, but it goes to the 25. Takes it up the middle. Good return.
The 45 over to the 47-yard line. So excellent starting position for Daveville. So returning the kickoff was Cordy Jefferson. So Daveville will take over first and 10, leading 21-0 in the third quarter. And here comes Jay Burns, a senior quarterback, 6'2", 200 pounds. Out to lead this Tiger offense. He'll have Brandez Eason back there with him. B.B. Comer's got everybody stacked up eight-man front, basically. And here is Eason. Eason stutter-stepping, reversing his steps, but B.B. Comer not fooled.
He'll get up to about the 50-yard line, finally brought down by Raylan Sims.
You know, we talked about Sims. He plays both ways, too, as most of these Tigers do.
So he's one of the most – he's got to be one of the most tired on the field.
So second down and long for Daveville, leading 21-0 in the third quarter. They have Eason at quarterback as Burns checks out, and Daveville's going to call a – timeout with 11:14 to go. Let me mention some of our sponsors here tonight that make high school football possible. Sylacauga Parks and Rec. Man, I appreciate those folks over there and what a great job they do. And always got something going on at the Parks and Rec, whether it's the seniors or whether it's having something at Central Park or just being in our community. It is Sylacauga Parks and Rec. Couldn't help but notice, you know, they're putting in new playground equipment at the Noble Park here in Sylacauga, and they've got all the old equipment removed, and they'll bring in the new equipment as Sylacauga Parks and Rec continues to grow. And so we appreciate them being a part of high school football tonight, as well as Daveville after the surprising timeout. Will come to the line of scrimmage, and they will have Jay Burns at quarterback. He had stepped out, but he's come back in. Burns keeps it, and Burns is in trouble, reverses his field, but B.B. Comer's got a lot of people around him.
He's brought down back behind the 50. Tristan Garrett's in there. Yeah, Caden Brown originally stops him from getting outside and holds him there for a minute so other guys can get to him.
B.B. Comer's not out of the football game, but it's very important that they make a stop here and get the football back.
Right.
You're down three scores and haven't shown a whole lot outside of Sims at quarterback. Penalty flag is down. That's going to be holding probably against Dadeville. Yeah.
Ja'Kari Brown got back there.
The official looked like he was a little confused there. He pointed toward B.B. Comer, and then he pointed toward Dadeville. And let's see where we're going to have it, holding against Dadeville. Kind of thought that was going to be the penalties declined, so it's fourth down. B.B. Comer will get the football back. So good stop by the Tigers to start the third quarter. First punt of the night for Dadeville. Moss to punt. Dadeville short of a player, getting a big tackle hurrying into the game.
It's Markevious Wilkerson.
Oh, he's going out now. I shouldn't have been in here to start with. They better hurry. They do get the punt away. It's a line drive punt that bounces inside the 25 to about the 20. So B.B. Comer, Zach, got to get some offense going. And let's see if Raylon Sims get this Tiger Club untracked here in the third quarter.
It would be great for the football team if they could score on this drive, get another stop, and then just carry on with there.
So first down and 10 for B.B. Comer at their 20, trailing 21 to nothing. We will be right back here at Legion Stadium next week for Sylacauga and Elmore County. Sims fires, caught, 30, 35, 40. 43-yard line goes Riley for Earlene's Flores first down.
Number three brought down by number three, Davis McKelvey on the tackle.
You know, Zach, we're getting very late in the season. Only two to three games left, and white knuckle time now.
Right.
Here's Sims to load up to throw again. He's in trouble. And he throws on the run, incomplete.
You know, I don't think he's gotten sacked. He might have got sacked once. He just knows how good to get away from pressure. And he's shown that tonight.
He's had to run for his life a lot of times.
Right.
So second down and 10. From the Tiger 43-yard line, trailing 21-0. Sims, a senior quarterback who's been Mr. Everything for the Tigers this season. Running room midfield, 43-yard line. That'll be an Earlene's Flores first down. So a nice hole by the Tiger offensive line.
Great run there by Tristan Garrett.
B.B. Comer opened up a nice hole for Garrett to run through, and that's the Tiger first down.
And he's getting the ball a lot more than he has been.
At the 44-yard line, B.B. Comer trying to put some first downs together here. Sims in trouble again, throws off balance, and it's off the hands of the intended receiver, Riley, who was free in the secondary.
It was a great ball. Just off the hands, though.
Riley said, I should have had that. So to bring up second down now. At the 44-yard line. hit at the line of scrimmage and slammed down for no gain.
Brought down by number 31, Dakari Daniels.
So third and 10. B.B. Comer is in four down territory, no matter where they are on the field. Third and 10 for Sims and the Tigers. 8:35 remaining in the third quarter, 21-0 Dadeville. Sims to load to throw, slings it out here and it's dropped. And open again was Riley, and it went off his hands, incomplete.
Man, Sims, he has a cannon though. I mean, you blink and you miss it.
So B.B. Comer sends their punting team out, kind of surprisingly, but they're going to punt it away. Riley's had some tough luck hanging on to the football on a couple of passes that he himself said he should have. Bounced around, falling on the football to the 45-yard line is Seth Pruitt, or Seth Pettit, and bad snap. And Pettit wisely falls on it, and Dadeville will take over in Tiger territory at their 45. So not a good spot for the Tigers to be in of B.B. Comer. Dadeville has it at B.B. Comer's 44-yard line. That is the third turnover of the night for B.B. Comer. The other two ended up with scores. Here's Jay Burns leading his team out. You'll leave it with Eason. Eason is inside the 40 to the 36-yard line.
Eason is brought down by number 65, Josh Ruiz.
Pickup of 7, second and 3. B.B. Comer's band had a different look tonight with their color scheme. Looked good.
It did.
Jefferson on the carry. Penalty flag is down. Holding against Dadeville.
Ja'Kari Brown on the tackle.
So we've had plenty of penalty flags thrown tonight. It'll be a 10-yard mark off. Back to the 47-yard line. 7:26 in the third quarter. Dadeville 21-0, Dadeville with a 3-touchdown advantage. Here is the Tigers. Quarterback keeps. And he falls forward to the 42. That is Jay Burns.
Brought down by number 55, Ja'Kari Brown. And number 50, Datron Wells.
B.B. Comer with a four-man front. Throwing on the run. In and out of the hands of the intended receiver, McKelvey. Incomplete.
Good ball.
So that'll bring up fourth down. Holding against Dadeville again.
That'll bring him back even further.
B.B. Comer may decline this. Let's see. It is declined, so Dable will punt. B.B. E.B. Colmer next week. They will travel to Lee Scott Academy in Auburn and then come back to close out the season against Thorsby. Lee Scott Academy is a pretty good football team too. First year in outside of private school. Moss to punt. So Dave will bounce inside the 15 to about the 11-yard line. High school football tonight brought to you by Erlene's Florist on the Talladega Highway in Sylacauga. Also, Donahue Physical Therapy. Our friends out at Toyota of Sylacauga partnered with us to bring you high school football tonight. And I saw one of the new Toyota SUVs. It's that gray color. Man, that thing looks so good. It's brand new. And you can check that out at Toyota Sylacauga tomorrow or next week. First down, B.B. Colmer at their 11-yard line. Sims in trouble, and he's going to be throwing incomplete. Boy, that was close to a safety there, but the receiver was in the vicinity, Richard Weed. That's very close to a safety.
Yeah, and Sims, I mean, he just won't allow himself to be sacked.
Strong young man.
Definitely.
So second down and 10. 5:56 remaining, 21-0 Dadeville. B.B. Colmer's got a long way to go and a short time to get there. In trouble again, rolling away from pressure. Now throws on the run, incomplete. Really, Sims not having a whole lot of time to do anything.
I mean, he's rolling out on just about every single play because the receivers aren't getting open. The O-line's not blocking properly. It's just a lopsided affair in terms of the defensive coverage.
The offensive line for B.B. Colmer, they've been challenged all year long. They've just not been able to get their line set the way Coach Fawcett wants it set. Third down and long. Sims again stepping away from pressure. He's on the move again. Throwing out of the end zone, and it is caught up here at the 28-yard line. And it will be a Tiger first down at the 27. What a great play again by Raylon Sims to get away from pressure.
Right. Caught by Richard Weed.
Weed came back to the throw, and he and Sims have done that quite a bit this year.
Right. You can see Sims pointing during the play, showing the receivers where to go. It's like play calling during the play. It's hard to do. But when you're as patient and as good at the game as he is, it's easy.
Nothing happening at the line of scrimmage.
This Dadeville run defense has been
a whole lot better in the second and third quarter than it was the first quarter.
Right.
But I remember you was talking about in the second quarter, it seemed like B.B. Colmer had it the entire second quarter and they have nothing to show for it. Second down and 10 from the 25.
Throws it deep, has a man.
Incomplete, intended for Riley again.
It's like every time, like I'm saying, just a single step too far for him.
So third down and 10. B.B. Colmer getting their team huddled up. Possession down for the Tigers here, trailing 21-0. 4-11 remaining in the third quarter over in Childersburg. Childersburg trailing Randolph County 21-6. Pressure coming after Sims again. He's dancing around. Sack back at the 7-yard line.
Golly, that's one of the first times he's got sacked. That's one of the first times that Dable has been able to catch up. I mean, brought down by number 10, Cordae Jefferson. When you blitz the right people, you can tackle him.
There goes 71 in there too, 6'1", 260-pound Marcavius Wilkerson. So you're right, that's one of the very few times that Sims had been sacked. And he is struggling. He's a guy that's taking a lot of load tonight for the Tigers. Pettit stands in his end zone to punt. Remember last time it was a low snap and he had to fall on it. Short punt. Very short.
Very
punt.
Short.
I guess a Tiger roll across the 30 to the 30. It'll stop at the 30-yard line. So excellent field position for Dadeville with a 21-0 lead. High school football tonight brought to you by Community Funeral Home, Charles Woods and Cadero Wood at Community Funeral Home. Been with us a long time and supportive of the student athletes. And we appreciate Charles and Cadero and the staff at Community Funeral Home, pre-need, at-need funeral services, funerals, burials, or cremations. Also, Bailey Heating and Air. Seasons are changing. You need that heating system service. It's Bailey Heating and Air on Highway 280. First and 10. For Dadeville from the B.B. Comer 30-yard line. Inside handoff, running room to the house.
And he's gone.
Goes. 20-yard or 30-yard touchdown run for Brandez Eason.
Just split the defense right there. Nobody could catch him.
27-0. That's the second touchdown of the night for Eason. So with a point after, Brady Knox kick is straight ahead, and the kick is true. So with 2:56 remaining in the third quarter, it's Dadeville 28, B.B. Comer nothing. We're back to Legion Stadium after this.
Listen carefully, you'll hear the roads of Alabama calling. And Sarah Honda has your answer during our Honda Summer Event. Serving you for over 40 years with a great selection of Honda and pre-owned inventories and the Sarah Promise. Take home a new 2024 Honda Accord for $259 a month for 36 months. Or a 2024 Honda HR-V for $269 for 36 months. Or receive a loyalty offer of up to $750 on a new Honda CR-V. Alabama can be yours to discover in a new vehicle from Sarah Honda in Sylacauga.
Back to Legion Stadium after the touchdown run from Brandez Eason. Dave will kick off to Comer. Gets to about the 17, returned by Raylan Sims. Doesn't get much, gets maybe past the 25, and is brought down by a herd of Dable Tigers.
Levi Childers along with Brody Buchanan bring down the kick returner for the Dable Tigers, leading 28-0.
Comer desperately needs to score here if they want any crackle of hope. Sims still in at quarterback, drops back, looking to throw. Nobody open, scrambles with it, and this time he gets stuffed. Nowhere to go.
Abernathy, a 6'4", 270-pound senior, knocks him down.
Nowhere to go for Raylan Sims. Looks like this Comer run defense and pass defense has really stepped it up a notch. And in the secondary, I mean, you know, the sign of Raylan Sims not throwing it is no receivers open. We'll try again here, second down. Another pass play. Oh, just a little too low.
A lot of pressure coming up the middle for Dadeville.
Intended for number three, De'Arian Riley. Had a man, just didn't have enough time to throw it.
Wilkerson along with Floyd putting pressure on the quarterback, Sims. And he, Zach, he is very favoring that left ankle.
And you'll hope that won't be long-term damage and maybe he just strained it.
Third down.
Jumps back again. Has a man this time, that's Riley. Brought down instantly.
Wow. Cordez Jefferson on the tackle, so that'll bring up fourth down. Just like that, B.B. Comer's punting again.
Seth Pettit's been active tonight.
You know, Dave only won one football game. They look a lot better than that.
Yeah, you know, you just look at their schedule, and the opponents haven't been easy. Pettit. Not a very long punt. Recovered at about the 45.
And this Jefferson with it to midfield.
Uh-oh. Oh. Looks like Kirksey was trying to step over the return man, and then the return man tried to get up, and Kirksey just fell on his back.
B.B. Comer trailing 28-0 with less than a minute to go in the third quarter.
Burns back there. Hands it off. That's Eason. Get Eason to the outside. Gets past the 40.
Taken down by Richard Weed. Now this Eason kid, he's an excellent player, just a junior.
And they will mark it at just about the 38-yard line.
Sideline warning to B.B. Comer. Under a minute remaining in the third quarter, Donahue Physical Therapy. Third quarter, Legion Stadium.
Looks like they got in. They still got in Burns. Burns with Eason in the backfield. Puts Eason in motion to the left, right side. Hands it off to him again, but this time it's instantly shut down.
Big 71 just blew it all up. Over in Childersburg, Randolph County knocking out Childersburg 35-6. That's Wilkerson on the tackle again for Dadeville. Excuse me. Yeah. And, you know, Zach, B.B. Comer will travel next week as the third quarter comes to a close, and B.B. Comer traveling next week to Lee Scott Academy, and that's not going to be easy either. That's the end of the third quarter. Dadeville 28, B.B. Comer nothing. Back with the fourth quarter after this.
new Marble City Pharmacy in Sylacauga is your destination for the highest quality health care. Our remodeled and expanded pharmacy gives us the space to serve more patients. We've added a drive-through window for those times when you don't feel like getting out of your vehicle. And we still offer delivery within city limits. We feature a full line of over-the-counter medications and supplements. And don't forget our stunning new gift department. New building, same great people. Marble City Pharmacy, here for life.
Back to Legion Stadium as Dadeville leads Colmar Tigers 28-0. As we are just now starting the fourth quarter.
Colmar not used to being in this tight position, especially the last 3 to 4 years. Get this fourth quarter started. Dayton a little bit late getting out there.
We're going to have the ball on the 40-yard line. Have it on the right hash. Burns takes the snap, hands it off. Stuffed immediately. Cordae Jefferson on the run.
Colmar quickly in to make the tackle is Josh Ruiz. 65. BB Colmar playing a lot of younger kids now, and Levi Watson, an eighth grader's in there. You remember that eighth grade, don't you?
Maybe.
Dave will take him plenty of time.
Drops back to throw.
Goodness.
Nobody open.
Good tackle by Christian Jemison. I'm surprised that Dave was trying to throw the football. Uh-oh. BB Colmar's got an injured player.
That's not good.
That is never good. And
that's going to be Datron Wells, too.
That's number 50, Brantley Hudson, if I'm right on that. Am I right on that?
I think.
Seventh grader?
That's no seventh grader.
What it says.
I think Datron Wells, because I remember last year you would swap jersey numbers in between on offense and defense. 17 and 50.
Datron Wells, not that big. Is he?
Well, there's no seventh grader that big.
That's the latest. He sent that to me today, Fawcett did. So, anyway, we'll take a break and come back to Legion Stadium right after this. BB Colmar trailing 28-0.
Toyota of Sylacauga has you covered with exclusive VIP direct pricing. Enjoy incredible savings of up to $6,000 off the total suggested retail price on select Toyota models. Experience the thrill of driving a new or used Toyota car, truck, or SUV while keeping more money in your pocket. We don't have it on the lot. We'll find it for you. Drive home in style with VIP direct pricing at Toyota of Sylacauga with up to $6,000 in total savings. ToyotaofSylacauga.com or visit us Highway 280 in Sylacauga. Toyota of Sylacauga. We're worth the drive.
Bandits Bar and Grill is your stop for great food, family fun, and live music. Wednesday night, it's cornhole tournament. Thursday night, biker night. Don't forget about the live music, too. Great steaks, full bar, awesome appetizers, wings, nachos, tacos, and fried catfish. Stop in today or give us a call at 256-369-2920. That's Bandits Bar and Grill on Fort Williams in Sylacauga.
Back to Legion Stadium, just got word that that is Datron Wells wearing number 50. And he gobbled off the field. He appears to be okay, but is still limping severely.
I can't believe your granddad made a mistake on that.
Man,
You forgive me, don't you?
Yeah, I do, okay, of course. All right. It's okay. It's just a mental mistake.
A senior moment?
Yeah.
10:30 to go in the game. Clock running in the Amya fourth quarter. Dable 28, BB Comer nothing.
Dadeville punting for one of the first times tonight.
Blocked it.
Blocked. But they're going to recover it. Not going to change much. Yeah. Better now, for Comer.
That was
55 is Ja'Kari Brown.
I think it's he that blocked the punt.
It looks like
I'm
Comer's.
Trying to figure out these. Yeah, that's what I said.
Comer's getting back there just about every punt that Dadeville has, but they just haven't been able to get the block.
They ain't punted many times.
Right.
So 10:02 to go in the game. B.B. Comer trailing 28-0. And the Warrior, Raylon Sims, is back out there. Whistles blow. Timeout on the field. B.B. Comer calls a timeout. You look at Coach Fawcett and frustration all over him. Coach Fawcett's a veteran coach. He has had stops at Winterboro. He's had stops at Childersburg. Latest stop, B.B. Comer. And this Tiger team, young, lost a lot of players off the last couple of years that contended for state championships. And they moved from 2A to 3A this year, and it's showing. They're a small 3A school.
Not saying they don't have talent. They have some talented players. Drops back to throw. Gets there almost instantly. Nowhere to go.
Too much pressure. Big 54. Gabe Abernathy, 6'4 senior. Come right up the middle. Clock stops with the incompletion. B.B. Comer next week will travel to Auburn to Lee Scott Academy.
Drops back to throw again. Nowhere to go. He gets it to the lineman.
He's not supposed to catch it now. He looked good, though.
He did. Looked like he was ready for his moment.
So is that Brown, or who is that?
Yeah, that's Caden Brown, yeah. The junior.
You know, he looked good at shuffling his feet.
He got hands, too.
Yeah.
Think they got to let him play that one out.
Come on now. Penalty against B.B. Comer. Brown says, hey, I'm not letting that opportunity get by me, though. But again, tremendous pressure on Sims, and now B.B. Comer brings in Fawcett, the quarterback.
Fawcett with the throw. Riley gets to the outside and is finally slung down close to the 50. Max Fawcett with his first completion.
Ja'Kari Daniels, a sophomore, there on the stop too. Yeah, Max is young, sophomore, and he will be the quarterback probably next year.
Gets his first varsity completion. Cops about to throw again. Good ball. Just behind him, though, just out of the hands of De'Arian Riley.
Kelby there to swat it away, so to bring up fourth down. Seth Pettit will punt it again. Seth's a senior. B. Comer has been shut out so far tonight.
Deep punt to the 20. Return. Good return. Gets him about 15 yards on it. It's number 10 on the turn back. Cordae Jefferson called his name a lot tonight.
Michael Kirk's it out on the tackle.
.824 left to go.
You know, the highlight of B.B. Comer's night was that goal line stand.
Right. It was a great defensive stop that led to them having a pretty decent drive, but just having it all go to waste and punting it away. Here it is, Jefferson again, gets to the outside, past the 40 to about the 42. Jefferson with a great run.
Caden Brown not giving up. He was chasing him from behind. Caden's a junior. He'll be back next year.
From their own 43. Burns back there.
I don't know why he's running the play clock down, because the game clock's not running.
Takes a snap, and De'Arian Riley jumps off sides.
Gabe Abernathy.
Oh.
Tackle. First.
Yes, didn't see it. So Comer catches a break, and that will back them up.
Next week we'll be here at the stadium for Sylacauga and Elmore County. Sylacauga off this week.
He's brought down. Nowhere to go on that one. Number 55 on the tackle, Jakari Brown. Called his name a bunch tonight. He's been in on tackles left and right.
Clock running, under 8 minutes remaining in the game. Omnia fourth quarter tonight from Legion Stadium.
Jefferson in the backfield again. Burns will drop back to pass. Sees a man, and it's caught.
Oh my goodness, what a catch.
What a catch. That's Davis McKelvey. He's just a sophomore.
All the way down the 25-yard line.
Fantastic grab over the defender.
Penalty flag is down, and we'll bring that one back.
Man. I mean, penalties have just killed them. They've hurt both teams.
Stop and Shop Auto Sales, one of our wonderful sponsors tonight. Anderson Collins, and they're participating in that Heritage South Federal Credit Union card sale that's going on for a couple of days here in town. If you're looking for a previously owned vehicle, car, truck, SUV, or Jeep, it's Stop and Shop Auto Sales on West 1st Street in Sylacauga.
Again. That's number
Gabe Abernathy moving.
Gabe Abernathy. 6'4" senior.
Wind that clock back up. It's under 7 minutes now. Been a long second half.
Nowhere to go. Gets maybe four out of that one as Burns doesn't have anywhere to go, and the clock will tick to under 6 minutes.
Kirksey on the tackle. Temperature dropped down into the upper 40s now, about 49 degrees, and some of the crowd is headed to the house. So another punt forthcoming.
Almost blocked again.
That was a weird looking thing. Didn't go 10
very,
yards.
Very strange. Recovered at the 42 by Cordae Jefferson.
That was an odd looking punt for sure.
It's been an odd game.
High school football tonight brought to you, of course, by our friends at Sylacauga Glass. Debbie and the staff present, they've been doing this for years, the National Anthem, which is so, so important to so many, many people.
So
Sylacauga Glass on Broadway here in Sylacauga, and Bandits Bar and Grill on West Fort Williams, bringing you high school football. They feed our broadcast team every week as well.
See what I was talking about earlier. You got Max Fawcett in at quarterback and Raylan Sims in at receiver. Fawcett has a man. That's Riley. Slung down. That's Davis McKelvey on the tackle, and he has been everywhere tonight, making tackles left and right, and, you know, getting that big catch, even though it was called back. Fantastic catch.
Clock running, your 5 minutes to go in the game, 28-0 Dadeville.
Fawcett and Garrett in the backfield. Fawcett too far behind the intended receiver, Riley. As the clock will stop at 4 minutes and 47 seconds.
Kelvey out there on the coverage for Dable. Be a nice ride home for Dable after a big win tonight over B.B. Comer.
Yeah.
Picking up their second win of the season.
Fawcett to throw.
Uh-oh.
Gets out of the pressure. Great job by Fawcett to get out of pressure and deliver the football to Garrett. Garrett cuts back upfield. Still going. He might go all the way.
Great run.
Garrett just out of bounds at the 12-yard line. Great job by Max Fawcett to get out of trouble and deliver the football. And Garrett gets an extra 20 yards on it.
You know, Fawcett's a young kid, but he kept his cool then.
He did.
And didn't succumb to the pressure and got it out to the receiver. And B.B. Comer, their best drive of the night.
So Max Fawcett showing promise at quarterback. Rolls out right. This time nowhere to go.
And Levi Childers with the sack. Fawcett is hurt. Fawcett very slow getting up. Baker makes the tackle. his head jarred that turf. That's never a good feeling, is it?
Nope.
Approaching 3 minutes to go in the game. Evie Comer trying to get on the scoreboard for the first time tonight.
Takes a snap, drops back, looking to throw, rolls out right again. Avoids the sack. Virtually the same exact play.
Yep. And look at this.
And it's
same
working.
Fumble.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my goodness. Caught it.
What in the world?
Oh, goodness.
That was one of the hardest hits I've seen in a while.
When it goes bad, it goes bad.
I don't blame him for fumbling. That came out of nowhere.
Let's see how they sort this thing out.
My goodness.
What a lick was passed.
Fawcett does a great job of getting away from the sack again. Throws it at basically the same play from earlier. And it looks like that might be Fawcett down.
You're right. That's his daddy helping him up. Get off the field. He's took some licks the last three or four plays now.
But he's done what he could.
So you're right. It's almost duplicate play.
The same exact play, but a completely different outcome. I mean, he delivered hardest hit I've seen. The hardest hit of the game for sure.
It's a fourth turnover of the night for B.B. Comer, and Dable's got it at their own one-yard line, turning away B.B. Comer again with 2:49 to go in the game.
Just don't want to give up a safety here. 28-2 don't look too good.
Just going to try to get it out from the shadow of their own goal line.
Comer is going to send the house.
And they almost got the safety, but he broke out of there about the 5 to the 7-yard line.
That's Jefferson.
Whistle's blowing again.
Can't go a few seconds without hearing a whistle. Dylan Davenport checking into the game. Ninth grader.
Clock running toward 2 minutes. We thought B.B. Comer might get a touchdown, but not to be. As of now. Of course, Dave will not in any hurry at all.
They're going to try to make this the last set of downs of the game. He'll be brought down at just about the 10, maybe to the 11-yard line.
Caden Brown had his arms around the quarterback. And also Dylan Davenport. B.B. Comer's got a player down on the field with the clock running at a minute 20. And they're going to have to stop as the public address announcer says, hamburgers at half price. That's Brown coming off the field. Limping. He's played a pretty good game now.
He has.
Minute to go in the game, 28-0 Dadeville. B.B. Comer is going to fall to 2-6 on the year. Dadeville will pick up their second win. Run that play clock all the way down. There's only 40 seconds to go in the game. We'll wait for the final couple of seconds of the play clock before he snap it.
He's not going down. Burns getting past the 20 to maybe the 23. Does not want to go down, and that is how this one's going to end.
Wind that clock, and Dadeville will go down Highway 280 to Tallapoosa County very happy as they have come to Sylacauga to Legion Stadium and knock out the BB Comber Tigers to the tune of 28-0. Coach Fawcett, the Tigers have felt the bite of another set of Tigers tonight, as it was all Dadeville most of the way. And Zach, B.B. Comber played hard, they fought hard, but just not enough ammunition tonight.
Yeah, you know, it's not as far as apart as the score seems, but Dadeville was definitely the better team tonight. They showed that. Comber's offensive line's got to step up their game a little bit. Raylan Sims can't be the only producer on the team. But I feel like we saw some improvement from some wideouts, from some defensive players. Definitely felt like it was a better game than it could have been.
B.B. Comber falling to Dadeville by a score of 28-0. The Sarah Automotive High School Game of the Week brought to you by District 33 State Representative Ben Robbins, Donahue Physical Therapy, Bailey Heating and Air, Toyota of Sylacauga, Marble City Pharmacy, Sylacauga Parks and Rec, Omnia, Heritage South Federal Credit Union, Community Funeral Home, Earlene's Florist, Stop and Shop Auto Sales, Sylacauga Glass, Coosa Valley Medical Center, Bandit's Bar and Grill, and Curtis and Son Funeral Home. Your final from Legion Stadium in Sylacauga tonight, the Dadeville Tigers over the B.B. Comber Tigers, 28-0. Thank you for watching. Until next time, God bless you. God bless America. Stay safe, everyone.